Yo, what's up guys, welcome back for another Death Row Duel video. Next match, Cross Bellnis Cup, second match here in the top 16. So yesterday we saw that Hieretics Dark Matter Hieretics won its matchup. First match here, top 16, against Formula Monarchs. So, the first deck for the top 8 playoffs is already known. Second match here on the top right corner, we have Evil Swarms versus Head. So, two very big decks in this game's history. So, let's take a look at both deck lists. The first decklist, of course, we have Corey McDuffie's Head decklist with the Giant Hand in the extra deck, the Full Hand Engine, the Mermaleo, Traptix Mermaleo, Darania Artifact Engine, and so on. You know, Head, Hands, Artifacts, and Traptix. And then the second decklist, we have Evil Swarms, pretty much at full force with all of those back rows, the Triple Compulsory, Double Mirror Force, Double Torrential, Double Bottomless, the Warning, the Solemn Judgment, very, very nice. And also Double Rabbit in the main deck, absolutely disgusting to pretty much instantly go for Ophion. So which deck has the advantage? It seems that Evil Swarms as the anti-meta deck has the advantage, since it completely shuts down the artifact engine of Head, so no Moral Tech, no Sanctum if Ophion is on board with one material attached. Although, if you see the hands here in the Head decklist, hands are a big threat for Evil Swarms. And Evil Swarms don't have access to Dweller, so no Dweller in the Evil Swarm extra deck. So it seems that if Head can draw into the hands and can keep the hand engine going, then Head has the advantage. So not wasting any more time, let's hop into the first game. Alright, first of all, I think I get to start, so let's see. I open up with a very good hand, so normal summon Traptix Mermaleo, immediately search out my Bottomless, I believe, only setting two cards, since we know that the Evil Storm decklist has access to a Heavy Storm, so I don't want to get blown away by Heavy Storm just in case he has it, and I think I have to set two, since again, I don't want to just lose to one Mystical Space Typhoon. You know the dilemma of setting one or two back row. I run into Heavy Storm, just set my Ice Hand, and he knows that I'm playing the hands, he attacks into it. So I was like, okay, I'm going to pop one of your back rows and go for Fire Hand, but he reveals Solemn Warning, so that makes sense, him attacking into my phase down monster. Double Typhoon here on both parts. He runs into Torrential Tribute, kind of forcing out that Pandemic spell card. So brutal to protect your Ophion. And yeah, I'm left at 1700 life points, so it's not looking too great unless I top deck into a hand. But here, Gull of the Hounded, again, was also a very nice top deck. He does decide, yeah, not to attack. Okay, I'm fine with that. So I try to attack into his Heliotrope. I believe the name is the normal Evil Swarm. Try to pop one of his back rows and eventually go for what's it called? Fire Hand. Again, attacking over the Heliotrope and so on, you know. And yeah, the game is somewhat stale now. Although, that top decked Dionea was a very nice top deck here on my part. So instantly go for 1-1 Arknight to take control. Put that Ophion to one of its exceed materials. So now my set Sanctum is live. I can go for Moral Tech to pop his Heliotrope. And here I can try to attack for game. Bar Mirror Force, of course. So set that, at least, yeah, put the Ice Hand in defense and attack for game. So second tool, my opponent gets a start and he opens busted. He opens broke. He has Corrigeon in his hand. He has that double summon monster. Forgot the name. And set 4. I also think one of his back rows is Solemn Judgment. So what more? Okay, yeah. What do you need more as an Evil Swarm player, right? Yeah, there's a cat. Yeah, the caster. I know caster gets the effect also if it's bottomless, but he does have Corrigeon. I didn't want him to normal summon, use his second normal summon for the turn to normal summon Thunderbird. You know, the card that can dodge trap cards, spell or traps, or whatever. So that's why I bottlenessed the caster earlier, but he did have access to double, double Pandemic. So he was able to kind of protect all of his setup and double Ophion. One Ophion is life with one material, but it's not really going to matter. He has to Compulse here, otherwise I would have blown him away with Excitonite Exiton, but what can I do, right? So 1-1, game number 3. I get the start, I have the advantage. So open up with Maxi. Not that great of a card against Evil Storms. Bar that rescue Rabbit. Immediately send to the grave for the 1-4 run draw here. Bottomless both his monsters. Let's try to bottomless both his monsters. Does he have a pandemic? Of course he has. He always has. And of course, Noah. I'm not going to think about this. Immediately, Solemn Mourning his Ophio. Normal Summon Dionea. Try to reborn that Murmuleo and pop one of his back rows, he judgments this. Okay, fine. He loses half his life points. I'm fine with that. My artifact engine is still alive, so flip over Sanctum. Sanctum special summons Moral Tech. Moral Tech to pop one of his monsters. And yeah, I do have that Trap Tricks Trap Hole in my hand. Set it and also Carl set, so I decide to just normal summon Fire Hand. Fire Hand to deal damage to get the pressure going. So again, yeah, my opponent really doesn't have a lot of answers to the hands. Maybe that one Evil Swarm Exceed monster that protects protects itself from being targeted, I believe. Not really sure about the effect, but yeah, he knows that I have that Fire Hand, and now, yeah, he cannot banish that Thunderbird anymore, and we are in the damage step, so pop his monster, special summon Ice Hand, and now I can't lose this one, right? Not taking any risk here, just going to attack, get in for some damage. I have like 4 back row set. So, which is not really something he can top deck. He top decks into that second bunny, but it's not alive since I think he only has one normal left. Normal summon Dionea, tried to pop one of his back rows, but run into Torrential Tribute. Okay, no big deal. I still have my Sanctum that I can use during my opponent's turn. Go for Moral Attack, and I think he only top decked one back row. Eventually decide to just MST it. Worst case scenario, it's a compulse, one of his compulses, but in this case, it was a Torrential Tribute, so Moral Tech can deal the necessary damage and attack for game. So hands, artifacts, Trap Tricks win the matchup here against Evil Swarms. Yeah, kind of unfortunate for Evil Swarms, because of the hands, you know, the hands have an excellent matchup, are excellent cards against the anti-meta deck against Evil Swarms, but yeah, if you see the pairings here, the matchups, the possible matchups, then if Evil Swarms would have won this one, they would have definitely had a lot of chances to get it all the way through to the finals. But Het do win this 2-1, so Het move on to the top 8 and will face off Hieretics in a top 8 match. So guys, that's it. Thanks for watching and feel free to leave a comment or a like if you enjoyed the video. Leetem signing out. Peace.